Baseball Analyst Joel Klatt. Joel, welcome. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Happy New Year. New Year. Yeah. See Shannon?
No.
I'm here the day after. Okay. I haven't seen you yet. If you haven't seen someone, you can say
okay, you get till Wednesday, Joel. You get to the 3rd.
Wednesday and
you're even to be February 13th. Talk about Happy New Year.
Joel, are you surprised by Alabama's performance?
No. In fact, I thought it was the least surprising thing of the entire day. You know, I was actually pretty surprised that Clemson laid the egg that they did, in particular with Kelly Bryant's form in the last 3 or 4 games to end the regular season. I was surprised that Jake Fromm for Georgia had so much poise in his last drive in the fourth quarter. I was surprised at the conservative nature that Oklahoma took late in that game offensively. The least surprising thing of the day was that Bama played great on defense. That's what they do. Since 2007, there's been no team in college football that has held more teams to under 200 yards. 49th time. Does that make sense?
Scale!
49th time.
Did you know that?
Wait, you're cherry-picking stats.
No, that's just 49 times they've held opponents under 200 yards. You know the next closest team?
Who the next closest?
Next closest. TCU with 29.
What?
20 games.
We torched TCU twice this year.
20 games. Listen, that team came out with a purpose, a very clear purpose. They were going to reestablish their identity on the defensive side. And let's face it, if Nick Saban has a month, guess what he does? He shuts people down. They shut out Michigan State 2 years ago. They held Washington. Washington didn't have much of a chance in that ballgame. The only team that had a chance was one of the most physically gifted and talented teams I've seen in a long time, which was the Zeke Elliott Ohio State team that could actually just sit there and line up with Alabama. But when you're overmatched like Clemson was last night.
Ohio State scored 42 in that game, and Zeke ran for 230.
Yeah.
But look at all those first rounders they had on that team.
All of them. The offensive
Joey
line.
Bosa, all those guys were there.
Here's another aspect, and I do want to bring up that game as a comparison because I know that that's going to be one of the things in your arsenal that you bring up, right, is these games. Do you understand that if you can't get the ball down the field against Alabama, you have no shot. No shot. Michigan State couldn't do it. Mm-mm. Washington couldn't do it last year. Nope. And Clemson had no plan to push the ball down the field. And this was very obvious that when you give Saban a month to prepare for Clemson, he's going to shut you down. But when Clemson only had 1 week to prepare for Alabama, they were able to get things done, in particular with Deshaun Watson.
That's it. Clemson had Deshaun Watson. And as I told him earlier, the drop-off from Deshaun Watson to Kelly Bryant was like going from Tom Brady to Tom Savage. That's how severe it was because...
I don't know about that.
Well, seriously... Yeah. Kelly Bryant was horrendous last night, and I'm with you. I watched him, I don't know, 4 or 5 times. I thought he was decent.
He was getting better. Yeah, no doubt.
He looked like he could throw it a little in the regular season games, and all of a sudden you put him on this stage under those lights, under that fire from that defense, and he just crumbled. He can run it a little bit, but he couldn't throw it a lick last night. And if you can't throw it a lick, you got no shot.
No.
And Etienne is not bad, and he got his bell rung early in the second quarter, and then he was pretty useless the rest of the game. So I thought they could establish a little bit, just like a credible bit of run. And then, as you brought up, Minka Fitzpatrick is really good. He's the best DB in the country, and they just put him on poor little Hunter Renfro and just said, no.
He didn't have
you
a chance.
You can't have him.
You take a possible top 5 pick and put him on a former walk-on.
You do. And the walk-on's pretty he's pretty shifty.
He shows what Coach Saban thinks about him.
That's correct.
True. And he made 2 nice catches late in that last ill-fated drive that resulted in no points. But the point is, Minka said after the game, I put hands on him. And he did. He just got up and got physical with him and took him out of the game and took the security blanket away from the young quarterback who was just lost. But all that said, don't forget this. Clemson has the ball and is actually driving the football and is all the way down to 1st and 10 at the Alabama 35, and it's mid-third quarter, and it's still only 10-6 Alabama. And all of a sudden, Kelly Bryant drops back, and these are just back-to-back bad luck plays, and he gets blown up as he's trying to throw, and the ball squirts sideways. And the big fella, Payne, just snatches it. He did. He made a nice catch, and he rumbled and stumbled down, and he gets a horse collar, and all of a sudden they're in business, 1st and 10 at the 27 of Clemson, and go boom, 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 touchdown, and now it's 17-6. And then the very next play, so 13 seconds later, Kelly Bryant tries to force one in. The ball gets batted up in the air, and it's pick 6.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden it goes from 10-6 to 24-6, and the game is over. Well, it was really a 2-play game, and that was it, ball game. But until that point, I'm just saying, well, this is like a 50-50. This is, I wasn't sure anybody was going to score more than like 14 points, yeah. You know, 16 points maybe.
I'm not surprised Alabama won. I'm surprised with the relative ease at which they won.
Because was it that easy?
Yeah, Skip, because I don't think Alabama ever felt they were in jeopardy. Because Clemson had shown no signs that they could consistently move the ball. And so unless they got a pick six or they got a scoop and score, the likelihood of them driving the ball 70 yards, 80 yards, because remember, Alabama kept them backed up. So now all of a sudden you're going to have to drive. You're not against Alabama unless you got – see, Skip, when you talk about Deshaun Watson, he showed – look what he did to Belichick's defense. Look what he did to the Legion of Boom.
I love him.
What he can do. Cam Newton. Yeah. So we're talking about guys that have extraordinary college careers.
Correct.
But they've been that in the NFL also. A guy that can only run the football, he's got to be more than serviceable to beat Coach Saban. Because his defense, they're predicated in choking off the run.
Yeah.
They got to make you one-dimensional, Skip, because they play a base 3-4, and they like to keep big people on the field. Well, now, if they can't stop the run, they got to take those little big people off and put little guys on there. Now you start back running. He wants to tell you, dictate to you, you're throwing the ball in this situation. We know it. Okay, we're ready. But when he can't dictate with Zeke, because you keep thinking about Zeke ran for 230, but Cordell Jones picked up a lot of third downs with his legs, and he made some clutch throws.
And they threw it down the field.
Remember how
they would attack down the field. Those safeties get a little bit softer, and then all of a sudden you hit a three-man front right there on one side of the center. Another thing, guys, is you bring up, you know, it's only one play or two plays, and I agree. Listen, 10-6, you think, boy, Clemson's got a little momentum. However, that was after Alabama had turned the ball over in their own territory, and Clemson only got a field goal out of it. Mm-hmm. That's when I thought to myself, okay, this isn't happening.
They didn't get a yard, and then Jalen Hurts. Calvin Ridley is like 10 yards behind the secondary. All Jalen Hurts has to do is throw the ball. He underthrows it, the safety gets back in and makes the play. If that score gets to 17-3, it might end up being 31-3.
Yeah, you never know. You never know.
They threw for 120 yards. That's not impressive.
When they asked Coach Saban, what did he say against Auburn? He said, we got away from our identity.
Yeah.
They gave up 168 rush yards to
Skip, on 49 attempts.
Okay, but it's what Auburn does, and you couldn't stop them from doing what they do. Now, they trick you. It's all misdirection, but it's clever.
A little different offense. But Stidham threw the ball well.
He threw pretty well.
So we're going to see, because I don't believe Sonny Michel and Chubb will run the football effectively against Alabama like they did Oklahoma. So now the true freshman will have to play big. Oof. Now, you know Coach Saban, you know what he likes to do with true freshmen. He'll come get you.
Georgia's going to do, or at least try to do, something that I candidly haven't seen in the Saban era, which is
line up in the eye.
Just go to the center of the ring and say, let's go. I mean,
who they are.
Good luck. Yeah. I guess. I mean, that's why. Clearly,
LSU tried to do it two straight years with Leonard Fournette.
It didn't even come close.
Went nowhere.
It didn't even come close.
It's hard to line up in I formation and say, we're going to pitch it to you or we're going to hand it to you and run the ball down his throat. He goes and gets a certain type. If you look at all his linemen that he sent to the NFL, they're all built the same way, Skip. Mm. They're about somewhere between 6'3 and under, and they're like 325. Mm-hmm. That's what he wants. Because he refuses to let you run the football.
Yeah.
But if you can run it a little, just a little, but you got a quarterback, you look at the quarterbacks that's beating Johnny Manziel, the Tebow, the Cam Newton, the Deshaun Watson, the Chad Kelly.
Trevor Knight, I can keep.
Yeah, but what did he do to Trevor Knight when he got him at Texas A&M? Beat the brakes off him.
Yeah, but what did Trevor Knight do to him in the Sugar Bowl?
What do you mean on and on, by the way? We're talking about a decade. We're mentioning like six guys, and you're like on and on. Like 49 times they've given up less than 200 yards.
Trevor Knight put up 45 on Alabama in a Sugar Bowl? This is Trevor Knight. I'm not talking about Deshaun Watson.
Okay, let's just say for the sake of argument, they play 12 games a year. So that's 120 games. You pick out eight. What happened in the 100?
I'm picking out the championship, the bowl games. I'm only doing bowl games.
Okay, what?
I'll throw in one kick six game where he gave up 34 to Auburn. But
you know he's going for a fifth national title.
Okay.
I'm just saying, nobody's ever done that.
I'm only going back the last 4 years, and it's like one big disaster after another. Deshaun scores 40. Deshaun scores 35. That's a lot of points.
I mean, he was a transcendent player. Deshaun was
Cam Newton.
I mean, look at what.
Look at what Johnny did. Skip, Johnny McZad had what?
It's St. Nick we're talking about. Don't give me transcendent player when you got St. Nick.
Well, I mean, listen, any metric that you can possibly bring up, they're the best defense, they're the best team in the last decade.
Okay.
Metric that you can possibly bring up. Okay. Now, there are going to be occurrences where a great player, a transcendent player, a couple of Heisman Trophy winners, a guy that should have won the Heisman Trophy.
Trevor Knight?
I mean, you're talking about like one or two instances in a decade where a guy that's not a Heisman Trophy caliber player actually beats them. 49 times they've given up less than 200 yards. That's 20 more than any other team in college.
And in college game. Mm. I mean, a 300 yard game.
But those are overrated SEC games. Seriously, those are Vanderbilt games.
You've got me.
He don't play Vanderbilt.
This year, the bulk of their conference was extremely overrated, except for these two that we're going to see in the national championship.
Behemoths.
But the previous, 8-9 years, that's a tough argument.
Why you know what?
That used to be a
Why did they go to a playoff? Because they got tired of SEC teams winning. SEC teams were playing each other.
That's not quite true. They got tired of exactly what we're going to have on Monday, which was an SEC championship game. That's why we have a playoff, which is going to be interesting. Just in the future, this playoff goes, it'll be interesting because now we've got a team that didn't win their state championship, didn't win their division, didn't win their conference that's going to have a chance to play for the national championship.
All I know is that St. Nick got one huge break this year because he got in to start with when he didn't deserve to.
He did deserve.
Then he got Kelly Bryant, and now he's going to get a true freshman with a team that just runs the football.
Oh,
thank you, God.
But don't
I mean, if they don't beat Georgia, I'll maybe like inch closer to your position, but that's a tough
limb to climb.
They're
going to beat Georgia. This is on a silver championship ladder.
Getting in is one thing, but don't you got to do something when you get there?
Yeah.
I mean, what good is going to the restaurant if I ain't got no money to buy nothing when I get there, Joe? I just look at the menu like, boy.
Maybe someone will give you some.
Ooh, that Wagyu show look good. If I can just get that tomahawk.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show, and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed, or go watch a few segments from our other shows on FS1.